Hear my cry, God. Listen to my prayer. From the end of the earth, I will call to you when my heart is overwhelmed. Lead me to the rock that is higher than I. Psalm 61, 1 through 2. Dear Lord, thank you for not being a distant and aloof God. You are near to the broken and offer comfort to the suffering. When we are enduring the highs and lows of life, we are confident that your mercy, grace, and love are ever present. When the world leaves us beaten down and alone, we pray that you would lift us up and remind us of your goodness. When we are overwhelmed, would you be our courage? When we feel weak, would you be our strength? Lead us into your presence. Beckon us with your goodness and transform us from the inside out. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thanks for making prayer a priority in your life.
Follow this podcast and listen weekly to receive godly wisdom and practical advice for daily living.
Today's news at a glance, Oliver Anthony's new song, Rich Men North of Richmond, speaks to a rising cultural wave. An AI company joins forces with a Kentucky school district, and it doesn't go well. And wildfires in Canada spur thousands of evacuations. We know there's a lot of sad news out there in the world. We can't ignore it, but we can find hope in it. And that's our aim here at Pre-News. We pray earnestly that even the saddest stories offer a hopeful and reflective message. We can't always keep bad things from happening, but we can choose how we respond. And as for us, we choose to learn and love. Will we always do a perfect job? Of course not. Will we always try our best? You bet. Our first story is about how music reflects culture. Oliver Anthony's new song, Rich Men North of Richmond, has become a cultural phenomenon in just a week, raising eyebrows, sparking conversations, and inciting both accolades and disputes across the political spectrum. This song has been hailed as an anthem for the working class, with some praising its authenticity and others criticizing it for being offensive and divisive. Hailing from Farmville, Virginia, Anthony's song has struck a chord with an overlooked demographic, the underpaid working class. These individuals have seen their dollar taxed to no end and feel kicked down by a country prioritizing, quote, Richmond north of Richmond over their welfare. With lyrics like, Lord, we got folks in the street, ain't got nothing to eat, Anthony has captured the frustration and resentment simmering in many small towns and rural communities. Anthony's song has given voice to the sentiment of disempowerment and the perception that politics, on both sides, has failed the working class. Richmond North of Richmond has also proven the transformative power of social media in shaping the musical landscape. With 1.9 million streamed on Spotify and more than 13 million YouTube views in less than a week, Anthony's viral success is a testament to the democratizing effect of online platforms. No longer are chart positions solely determined by major record labels or mainstream media outlets. Social media has become a potent tool for the independent musicians like Anthony to reach the masses, transcending traditional gatekeepers and allowing listeners to engage directly with the artist. As a result, songs like Richmond North of Richmond can chart higher than established hits, revealing a shift in how music is being consumed, shared, and appreciated. There are a lot of other songs on YouTube or on TikTok that have so many streams that no record label can keep up. However, the reception of this song has not been uniform. Conservative figures laud the track as a protest song of our generation, but others accuse Anthony of harboring right-wing attitudes and shamefully attacking welfare recipients. The divide over the song reflects the broader polarization of the society we live in, and individuals interpreting the lyrics in ways that reinforce their existing beliefs and biases. The song's success and divisiveness offer us an opportunity to pause and listen to the struggles, fears, and hopes of those who might see themselves in Oliver Anthony's lyrics. It's an invitation to consider the dignity and worth of every individual, regardless of political stance or socioeconomic status. From a Christ-centered perspective, the song calls us to recognize the shared humanity in one another and to approach divisive issues with a spirit of compassion and dialogue. Whether you agree with Oliver Anthony's status or not, he is clearly resonating with a lot of individuals who feel forgotten, who feel disinherited, and feel disenfranchised with the status quo. Oliver Anthony isn't the only person in this country who feels forgotten, cast aside, and underappreciated for his work. Many Americans, from rural farmland to urban alleyways, feel like the wealthy and the ruling class have failed them. Music, as is the case with worship, is a tool to express our heart's deepest desires. It taps into cultural phenomena and cultural outcries. Consider the Psalms, a collection of melodies woven together to express regret, fear, awe, and love. Richmond, north of Richmond, is a song of desperation, much like Psalm 61. Hear my cry, O God, listen to my prayer. From the ends of the earth I call to you. I call as my heart grows faint. Lead me to the rock that is higher than I. For you have been my refuge, a strong tower against the foe. You see, we often feel forgotten, cast aside. Perhaps we feel disenfranchised with the status quo, or like we've been beaten down by culture. We want to cry out to God in our despair. To the ends of the earth, we want to call to Him, and we want to pray, knowing with full assurance that He has our backs. Ultimately, Richmond, north of Richmond, offers more than just a catchy tune. It serves as a mirror to our society's complexities, challenges, and opportunities for growth. Its impact on the forgotten demographic and the music industry at large vividly illustrates the power of authentic storytelling in our interconnected world. The song urges us to look beyond labels and truly see people and communities behind the rhetoric. In doing so, it challenges us to strive for a society where every voice is heard and valued, reflecting the Christian ideals of love, acceptance, and community. So let's lift this story up in prayer, knowing full well that God has us. Heavenly Father, may the music and stories that resonate with us open our hearts to empathy, understanding, and compassion. Help us to see beyond our divisions, and to listen to the struggles of others, and to strive for a society where every voice is heard and valued. Guide us to build bridges rather than walls, reflecting your love and grace in all that we do. In Jesus' name, amen. This next story is hard to hear for a lot of parents out there. The first day of school typically evokes feelings of excitement and anticipation. However, in Jefferson County, the largest school district in Kentucky, it transformed into an absolute nightmare due to a catastrophic failure in the newly implemented AI-designed bus routes. As the school year began, Jefferson County School District, struggling with a shortage of bus drivers, sought the help of Alpha Route, a company offering AI solutions to redesign bus routes. Paying hundreds of thousands of dollars for a modern solution seemed like the next logical step in dealing with low staffing. Unfortunately, the results were nothing short of a disaster. On the first day, some kids never got picked up, while others were dropped off hours late, even as late as 10 p.m. Horror stories of children left hungry, soiled, and traumatized poured in from worried parents. John Stovall, president of the union local that represents the bus drivers, warned that the drivers had been practicing the routes before the catastrophe and were loudly sounding the alarm. "They were calling me in tears, crying that this is not going to work," he said. Despite these warnings from the school bus drivers, the system was implemented, and the results were horrifying. Children were lost, dropped off in the wrong places, and in some cases, parents were left in terror, not knowing where their children were for hours at a time, and if they would even make it home. There are certain accounts of other parents helping find lost children and getting them back home where they belonged. This is a symptom of a larger issue that's been pervasive throughout the country. While the immediate response may be to blame the AI software or the company behind it, the root cause goes deeper. There has been a chronic shortage of bus drivers across the country. In Jefferson County, bus drivers' number fell from 900 to 600, leaving the country in desperate need of a quick fix, so they turned to AI. The national shortage of school bus drivers has reached a crisis point, and nowhere is this more evident than Louisville, Kentucky. What seemed to be an isolated and manageable problem has now grown into a systematic issue affecting school districts across the country. The shortage of drivers, not confined to Louisville, it extends to many other districts grappling with similar challenges. In Tampa, Florida, 203 bus driver vacancies persist, leading to delays on the first two school days. Charlottesville, Virginia has had to notify families of 1,000 children that there are no drivers in their route. In Chicago, around half of the district's bus driver positions remain vacant. Low wages and inconvenient hours are cited as the primary reasons for the shortage. Many districts, including Stillwater Public Schools in central Oklahoma, have increased the pay, but more is needed to solve the problem. The job itself has also become more demanding, leading to confrontations with parents and students. Creative solutions may be necessary, like turning to new software, to overcome the crisis, but raising pay is the most straightforward approach in the immediate. Schools might need to think out of the box to address the multifaceted issue. Some suggest offering ways for workers to have a voice in employing exit interviews to uncover root causes. Moreover, districts may need to reassess their strategies. The shortage has left many families scrambling to find alternative childcare solutions. Parents and guardians have expressed their anxiety and frustration, with some calling for accountability from school authorities. Jason Bailey at the Kentucky Center of Economic Policy points out that as private sector employers up their wages, the public sector must compete, or else these types of nightmares will become more common. In Kentucky, the General Assembly has shorted Jefferson County $104 million in transportation funds they were obligated to provide in the past 4 years alone. This tragic event not only brings to light the over-reliance on technology without proper human judgment, but also underscores the importance of community and empathy. In our faith, the concept of loving our neighbors and caring for the least of these is paramount. The situation in Jefferson County is a painful reminder that while technology can be a powerful tool, it must never replace the human connection, wisdom, and empathy that we are all called to. Altruism and genuine concern for the well-being of others, drivers and students alike, especially the students, should always be at the forefront of our decisions. And as it turns out, these two things intersect with one another. The Bible teaches us to bear one another's burdens and so fulfill the law of Christ in Galatians 6:2. In this case, the responsibility to provide safe and efficient transportation for children should not be offloaded to AI without human oversight. It's a shared responsibility of the community, the school district, and the local government to ensure the safety and welfare of the children. And reflecting on this situation, may it lead us to a renewed commitment to valuing human life, dignity, and community over expediency and profit. For it's in our compassion, understanding, and action that we truly embody Christ's love. So, with all this being said, let's lift this up in prayer. Heavenly Father, we lift up the families, children, and communities affected by this distressing situation. Grant wisdom and compassion to those in authority to find humane solutions, balancing technology with empathy and care. May we all be reminded of the shared responsibility to prioritize the safety and well-being of our children, reflecting your love and concern for the least of these. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our last story has to do with more devastating wildfires. In a grave and sudden turn of events, one of the largest cities in Canada's far north, Yellowknife, is facing an impending evacuation as warnings about a wildfire reaching the city by the weekend intensify. The capital of the Northwest Territories, home to 20,000 residents, has been put on alert and the citizens have been given until noon Friday to leave. The situation is dire as of late Wednesday, with the fire reportedly within 17 kilometers of Yellowknife. Hay River is another community under threat, and evacuation challenges have been exacerbated by the closing of the two highways out of the town due to rapid movement of the fire fanned by strong winds. The government of the Northwest Territories declared a state of emergency late Tuesday, grappling with over 200 wildfires across the region. Shane Thompson, the region's environment minister, stressed that the lack of rain and current trajectory of the fire mean that it could reach the city outskirts by the weekend. The evacuation has been a harrowing experience for many residents. Lisa Mundy, a resident of Yellowknife, described how her car began melting and her young son expressed his fear of death as they fled through the embers. Canada's military has been actively coordinating airlift operations, resulting in the largest airlift evacuation effort in Canada's history. Most evacuees are being transported south of Alberta, uncertain about where they're gonna go and how they're gonna get home. Communities such as Fort Smith, Hay River Enterprise, and Jean-Marie River are all under evacuation orders, and the community of Enterprise is reported to be 90% gone. The unprecedented wildfire season, with nearly 1,100 active fires burning across Canada, is being cited as the worst on record. Experts attribute this disastrous development to a warmer and drier spring than usual. As we reflect on this devastating situation, the core Christian values of compassion, community, and stewardship come to the forefront. The immediate concern is the safety and welfare of those affected, and it's a heartening demonstration of human solidarity to witness the community's efforts to support one another and the military responding. The response from the military and the local authorities reminds us of our collective responsibility to care for our neighbors in times of need. The call to stewardship also echoes profoundly as the root cause of these wildfires point to a changing climate. It reinforces our ethic of caring for the earth as a steward of God's land. In times of crisis, it is our faith that often provides strength and hope. And so we're going to be praying for those affected by these wildfires in Canada and the first responders risking their lives to protect others. May this event be a stark reminder of our shared responsibility to one another and to the world that God has entrusted us. So, let's lift this all up in prayer. Heavenly Father, we lift up the people of Yellowknife and the surrounding communities. Faced with the terror and uncertainty of these raging wildfires, we trust in your sovereign hand. Would you comfort those who need to be comforted? Strengthen the hands of the responders, guide the evacuations, and comfort those who are frightened and displaced. May this crisis awaken us to renewed commitment to care for the earth and each other, reflecting our love and stewardship. And it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for praying with us today. Continue your time with God by listening to today's Bible story.
And make Bible study and prayer the priority of your life. And if you are enjoying this podcast, let someone else know. Pass the good news around to others.
The podcast is a moving and inspiring biblical audio experience that will help you master wisdom from the world's greatest book. In each episode, you'll learn to apply biblical principles to everyday life.
Each cinematic episode is a journey through the Bible's most profound stories that will strengthen your appreciation of the Word and inspire you to keep learning.